Welcome, dear students. Let's move on to the next part of our chapter, Microorganisms, Friends and Foes. So we have seen the classification of microorganisms or microbes, and out of that classification, we will study about bacteria in this section. And we'll see what are bacteria, what are the different types of bacteria, what are their different shapes, and what is the structure of a bacterial cell. These bacteria are single-celled microorganisms. Single-cell, therefore, they can also be called unicellular microorganisms. Uni, where uni means one. So, single-celled microorganisms or unicellular microorganisms. They are said to belong to a specific group of organisms which is called prokaryotes. Prokaryotes. Now, if we split this term prokaryote, we'll get two words, pro and karyon. Here, pro means primitive type, that is the older version, and karyon refers to nucleus. So, if we combine both the meanings, we get that these bacteria belong to such group of organisms which have primitive type of nucleus. Now, what is this primitive type of nucleus? It means that the nucleus is not well defined. It is not well defined. It is not as much developed as it is present in higher grades of organisms. The other thing is its size. Its size varies from 0.2 to 100 microns. And the most important thing is that they are adapted to all types of habitats. They are found everywhere. Wherever organic matter is present, they can be found, like ocean bottoms, hot spring, dry deserts, inside and outside the body of other organisms, they can be found. The air we breathe in, it also contains thousands of bacteria. They are the most abundant microorganisms. For example, a handful of soil may contain hundreds and thousands of bacteria. So we can say that they are ubiquitous in nature, means they are found everywhere in all types of habitats. These bacteria may have different shapes, and according to their shapes, they have been given different names. We will study about four major shapes of bacteria. These are round-shaped, rod-shaped, spiral, and comma-like. So the bacteria which have round-shaped body are called coccus bacteria. This is the singular term coccus, and if we talk about in plural, we can say it as cocci bacteria. The other shape of bacteria is the rod-shaped bacteria, and these bacteria are called bacillus bacteria. Or the plural form is bacilli bacteria. Then the third category of the bacteria is those bacteria which are having spiral shaped body, and such bacteria are called spirillum, which is a singular term. We can say it as spirilla when we talk in plural. And the fourth category of the bacteria is the Vibrio bacteria. These bacteria have comma shaped body. If you can see from the picture, you can resemble it like a comma. So since they are having a comma shaped body, they are called as Vibrio bacteria. So in this way, we have seen four different shapes of bacteria: the round shaped coccus bacteria, rod shaped bacillus bacteria, spiral shaped spirillum bacteria, and comma shaped vibrio bacteria. Let us see the structure of a bacterial cell. if we see the microscopic structure of a bacterial cell, we'll see that there is an outermost covering of a layer which is of mucilage. Then after mucilage, you can see this colored layer which is of cell wall. And after cell wall, there is a thin membrane which is the plasma membrane. And from this plasma membrane, you can see number of hair-like structure. These hair-like structure are present in all the bacterial cells except the round-shaped bacteria. And if you can recall from the previous slide, you will see that I have made these hair-like structures on the body of rod-shaped bacteria, spirillum bacteria, and Vibrio bacteria, but not on the body surface of Coccus bacteria. Why? Because except the round-shaped bacteria, all the bacteria possess these hair-like structure. And these hair-like structure are called pilus. Now, besides these small hair-like structure, you can see some long thread-like structures also arising from the plasma membrane. And these long thread-like structures are called flagellum. In plural, they are called flagella. So, these flagella help in locomotion or in the movement of these bacterial cells or these bacteria. Now, besides that, I have told you that bacteria belong to a specific group of organisms, and that group is called the prokaryotic organisms. And I have told you the meaning of prokaryotes also. It means the organisms which have primitive type of nucleus. And what is this primitive type of nucleus? It says that they don't have a well-defined nucleus. And you can see it from here. The nucleus is not well-defined. It is not having any boundary. And it is called nucleoid. And besides all these structures, some food granules are also present inside the bacterial cell, along with the liquid which is present inside the cell, which is called the cytoplasm. So this is the structure of a bacterial cell.